Friends, today we are going to study about ultrasonic sensors. So ultrasonic sensors, and not only ultrasonic sensors, most of the sensors are actually inspired by the nature, like whatever we are seeing in real time, that is the base ground for making the sensors. You can see how ultrasonic sensors basically work. Like you see this bat, so how the works, how this bat actually finds that if any prey is there in front of that. So what it do, basically it produces ultrasonic sound, like it's a form of wave. So what happens when it propagates through air, it hits the target, and when it comes back to its ear, so the bat can actually estimate that how long it took, and based on that how long it took, it identifies that how much the distance of the prey. The same way ultrasonic sensors are also there. So what these ultrasonic sensors basically do, in this also same trigger and echo is there. So trigger and echo means what? Basically, you can see that this ultrasonic squeaks is the trigger, like this type of audio waves will come, and whatever return will come, that is called echo. Same way, our ultrasonic sensor also produces some trigger, means some audio, and that hits the object and it comes back to the echo. You can see that there is a transmitter and there is a receiver. So you can see this produces the squeak, it means the trigger, and this actually this is the receiver. So once it the audio waves comes back and hits to this one, it measures, you know, that already the speed of sound in air, in water, in every different environment, that is different. So in air, what is the speed of the sound, that it knows, and how much time it took. So you know that distance is equal to speed into time. So based on that, it identifies that what's happening here actually. So how much is the distance, based on that it identifies. So come the sensor, and now let's come to the practical. So at first we have to take the Arduino, you know that we have to take at first this one microcontroller board. So we'll take Arduino Uno. We'll type here Arduino and it will come. In previous class you have already seen that. Now here what you have to do, we have to use ultrasonic. So once you see this, one ultrasonic sensor will appear here. Now you should remember, that VCC is always, we are giving to the sensors is 5 volt here. So this 5 volt we'll take from here and we'll give it to this one. And you remember that color of positive 5 volt is red color. We have to always indicate like this. And ground is always black in color. You can easily overlap the wires here. That doesn't matter because it won't get short circuited. And for the black color, you know the color is black. I mean, for this ground, the color is black. Now, echo will connect in digital pin number 2. We will take to digital pin number 2. We will connect to digital pin number 2. We will give it some other color, maybe yellow. And for echo also, we will take one and we will connect it to pin number 3. Number 2. And we'll give this some other color, maybe. So you know that already, whatever the signal, first of all we have to power on this one. So for powering on this one, we have given 5 volt and ground, then echo and trigger. So you remember what is trigger and what is echo. So trigger means what happens, this yellow color signal, actually one audio signal will come from one signal will come from this one, and from transmitter it will go in air. And it will hit something and it will come back to the receiver. Receiver means this pin number 3, it will come back. So once it comes back to this one, what will our microcontroller will calculate this one? Well, how much was the time and what is the speed of sound in air and how much distance, how much time it took to go and come back. And based on that, it will calculate what is the distance, as distance equal to time into speed. So let's see the program. Program is also pretty simple. You can see that we have to go to the text-based code. You can see that here at first we have to declare that what pin is what. You know that directly we have declared last time. Last time actually you can straight away use here 2, pin number 3, and it will work. But here it's always better to give some name to the pin. So we just change here, it will change in the whole program. You don't need to change it manually to the whole program. So we declared it here. and what is the duration. What we are going, duration is nothing but that how much time it took to go and come, that duration. Then distance in centimeter, and that will be converted into inches also. You know that centimeter to inch conversion formula is there, that we'll use. So for that, we have to declare the data types in the pin. So that we declared here. Now, you know that setup program. So setup program is just, it runs only once. And here we declare that what pin is what, that is input or output. So you remember trigger pin and echo pin. You remember the trigger pin means what? In the explanation, I told you that trigger means that bat sends the audio signal. And echo means when it hits something and come back, then that is echo pin. So echo pin will always be input because it measures that how much time it takes to come back the signal, audio signal. Trigger is just sends the signal. So that is output and echo is the input. Now digital write trigger pin low. So whenever we want, we should be able to on and off. Whenever we want, we want to send the signal, that time only we should send. Otherwise, it should always be in the off condition. So for that, we are making initially the trigger pin as off condition. Now, digital loop, void loop, you know that this void loop program continuously runs. So what we'll do? Initially, we'll make this trigger pin high for how many microseconds? For 10 microseconds. Then digital write trigger pin low, will off this one, and we'll measure the duration actually continuously for every 10 microseconds. We'll send the signals and we'll measure how much time it's taking to come back. We are not continuously sending the signal, right? We are sending with a duration. So when the pulses of signals are keep on going and it measures that how much time it takes to come. So that will be calculated by this formula. Pulse in is actually the function inbuilt that actually measures that what is happening inside. So echo pin is high and pulse in actually checks the that what pulse is coming there. And here is the formula, duration multiplied by 0.034 divided by 2. So if you see that the time is this one and this is the speed. So if you see that what is the speed of audio in air, you'll be finding that you'll be getting some relationship here. Now, if the distance, this will give you the result in centimeter. So if you are getting the distance below 50 centimeter, what it should produce? Object is within 50 centimeter range. Otherwise, it should display you object is beyond 50 centimeter range. And after every delay of 100 milliseconds, it will be keep on, this process will be keep on repeated. So that is the overall thing. So once you do this one, we'll see the demo now. We'll start the simulation and we'll see how it works. Move it here a little bit and we'll start the simulation again. So you can see that if once I click here, you'll be able to see that what is the distance right here. Now if you go to code and go to serial monitor, in your case it will be like this. You have to click here on serial monitor and you have to see what is coming here. So in this you can see that its object is beyond 50 centimeter range. Why? Because we are out of 50 centimeter range. Try to bring it within 50 centimeter. Now you see, once you bring within 50 centimeter, what is coming? Object is within 50 centimeter range. Now in this, if you are doing some changes, like for example, we are making something for like in vehicle reverse parking systems. So in reverse parking, what is there? That our vehicle should not go, it should not hit the object. So what we'll do here, we'll just change it here. We'll change the range to 30 centimeter and we'll see that what happens here. If it goes below 30 centimeter, what will happen? It will come as warning. We'll make it in capital so it will look nice. Warning. And otherwise we'll write it here. Save. And in this we'll just start the simulation. So once we start the simulation, it comes below 30 centimeter. Yes. Once it comes below 30 centimeter, you will see that this warning is coming. And once it goes out of 30 centimeter, this safe is coming. Again, you see. So like this, you can make it actually this one reverse parking system using this very simple sensors. And your assignment is like you have to practice it with some display. Here you have to add some LCD display or something. Like you will get enough content. That how to add LCD here, and you can make a warning system. For example, you can connect one buzzer here, so if it is going to hit somewhere, it should always make a noise, it should glow some lights. So these are your assignments. You have to practice it with other components Like you have to add some speakers and you have to add some buzzer and LED, and you have to see that whether if it is going to hit something, it should give you some warning in real time. You can be as constructive as you want. Thank you.